All right, looks like we're live here, Johnny. Thanks for joining me, and welcome everyone to Box Elder High School tonight as the Box Elder Bees are going to take on the Lakers from Bonneville. We had Tuesday, we had Bees and Lakers again, except for that was softball. So maybe we'll get a better result in this game.
Today we should win this game. Box Elder is 3-3 in region. I'll focus on region. Bonneville's 0-5, although their game a couple of days ago against Clearfield had not yet been posted, so I don't know the result of that game. I should have asked Coach Stewart what that was, but this is a game that Box Elder should win, and quite honestly, should win handily.
Yeah, I think overall Bonneville record 3-12.
Yeah, and not counting the game of a couple days ago against Clearfield, so it could be 3-13 or 4-12. But Box Elder's sitting at 5-5, and I think there's probably a game or two in there that haven't been posted on Deseret News. But Box Elder has been continuously getting better.
That's been the thing I've enjoyed watching this year, is the progression from game to game almost.
Oh, yeah.
That we do. I mean, we don't do all of them, obviously, but.
No, but that makes the progression seem even that much bigger to us.
Yeah.
Where we aren't here for every game. We see that progress because there's a gap in between. And they have definitely gotten better. And they've played well, even though they haven't got wins against some of the better teams. Their last game against Bountiful, you know, they got a game out of that, and Bountiful is really, really good.
They're ranked number 4 in the state right now.
Yeah, and we lost 3-1, but I talked to Coach Stewart beforehand. She said it was really good volleyball. So she was in, you know, as a sports fan and a competitor, you hate the term moral victory, but let's be honest, sometimes that is real.
You got to have it.
If you go into a game overmatched, and you perform well, you walk out of there thinking, okay, we got some things to work on, but there was a lot of good in there too.
I'm going to be curious what the state playoffs are going to be like this year, because I don't think you can base the RPI off from that much.
No.
I think there will be some upsets this year.
There could be, and the RPIs are out. You mentioned them. I printed them out. The top 8 teams get a bye. The next 8 teams, so 9 through 16, get a first-round home game, and then the bottom 4 are left out of it. But Box Elder right now is sitting at number 16. You and I were talking before. I'm worried that the Woods Cross is at number 19, might pass us. They're a really good team as well. They're up near the top of region. They're sitting at 5-1. Bountiful's at 6-0. So I see Woods Cross passing us. So this is the kind of game that we need to win. And you need to come out and take charge and just make it happen. Don't give them any hope that they can sneak a game or two, or worst case scenario, 3 out of you.
Yeah.
It'll build your confidence. You're coming off of a pretty good outing against Bountiful. You want to come out and have your best game yet.
That's what they need right here tonight. You know, like I said, hopefully it's a better outcome than what the girls had in softball the other night. You know, have you paid attention to the softball RPI rankings?
Yeah, 3 of the top 4 are from Region 5.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome.
Box Elder's number 4, if I remember. And then you've got, and I forget who they are, Bountiful's number 2, and I believe it must be Bonneville. Number 3. So. But, you know, in softball and baseball and any other, well, any sport for that matter, when you play good competition, it prepares you for the state tournament.
Absolutely.
And that's where Box Elder playing Bountiful tough, that's going to help them in the state tournament, because that's the kind of competition you see after the first round.
And then tomorrow night we got baseball coming up as well, so.
And baseball on the RPI is kind of sitting about where the volleyball is. They're kind of right there in the middle of the pack as far as 5A goes. And, you know, those kinds of teams can be dangerous when they're in the middle. They're good enough. What that tells me is they're generally not consistent enough. But they're good enough to beat some of those top teams.
Yep. So Bountiful will be in the ballpark tomorrow night. So.
Well, that'll be fun, and I'm going to miss it because I'll be doing a soccer game.
And we will miss you.
Thanks, Bruce. Let's get back to volleyball. That's why we're here. Here's the region standings. You got Bountiful at the top, 6-0. Viewmont 5-1, as well as Woods Cross 5-1. So you have that Southern Davis County group.
Yep.
Those three Bountiful schools, they're all right there. And then Box Elder's coming in at 3-3, right in the middle. And then Clearfield 2-3, although they did have a game a couple of nights ago against Bonneville. I'm assuming they won, so we'd be tied for fourth with Clearfield, followed by Roy, Northridge, who each have a win, and Bonneville, who is winless in region play. And that's why I say this is a game that you have to win if you want the RPI. And I point to the sheet. Nobody can see me pointing but you. But if you want to stay where you're at and move up, this is a game you have to have.
Absolutely, yeah, because losing to a team that hasn't won very much, that can drop you pretty quick.
Yeah, and Bonneville is seated number 23. So we're getting ready for the anthem and start this volleyball game. This is going to be a lot of fun.
Turn things over to the announcer here in just a minute. They're twiddling their thumb there, trying to get the flag to come down.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to welcome you to Box Elder High School in tonight's Region 5 volleyball match. We welcome as our guests the Lakers from Bonneville High School. Before we begin our match, we would like to honor our country, so we would invite everyone to please stand, and Lydia Donaldson is going to sing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so
visiting Bonneville Lakers. Number 5, Talon Rocha. Number 13, Macy Christensen. Number 4, Levi Olson. Number 6, Cameron Howell. Number 11, Bryson Howell. Number 15, Tyler Cole. And number 7, JoJo Hall. For your Box Elder Bees. Number 1, Brent Blacker. Number 10, Peter Lang. Number 13, Dallin McKee. Number 15, Carter Buchanan. Number 4, Tice Johnston. Number 23, Canyon DeRica. And number 26, Brian Fifield. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, let's play ball.
All right, well, Bruce and I are trying to look up some rosters because they didn't provide one to us today. So I think we know the Box Elder players.
We can get most of them, I think.
But we apologize if anybody's tuning in from the Bonneville side. We just don't have a roster.
I'm going to run down and see if I can find one real quick, Johnny.
All right.
Keep everybody
we'll get started.
Entertained.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Bruce. All right, we got the referees setting up the lineups, everybody getting set. And we'll get started here quickly. We're gonna have Dallin McKee starting us off. Serving for the Bees. All right, a good hit back there by number 13 for Bonneville. And we do have a roster for Bonneville as they take a 1-0 lead. I might have said Woods Cross earlier. Got a lot of teams on my mind with all the different sports.
Excellent pass on that one.
Set a little bit behind, and Buchanan puts it long. Bonneville takes a 2-0 lead. This is not the start we wanted. We talked about, Boxhiller on paper should win. Got to take care of business quickly. And now it's 3-0.
Excellent block there by Christensen to kind of set the tone on that one. This is Rocha
and another
serving
one.
And gets the ace.
So I don't know if Boxhiller came in thinking like I did that they should win this game, but, If the team did that, that's a problem. Looks like number 6 from Bonneville came across and hit the net.
Howell on that one.
So Boxhiller gets their first point, and we got Carter Buchanan back serving. Good serve.
Excellent serve.
And some miscommunication on the part of Bonneville. Gives Boxhiller their second point.
That was a great kill there by Levi Olson.
No, Levi did exactly what he needed to do. And I think Boxhiller needs to get the block set up maybe a little bit better. He was kind of uncontested.
Brings up Christensen to serve.
Boxhiller with an opportunity here. Brandt tried to place it.
Free ball to the Bees. There was the set that they wanted.
Yeah, awesome job there by Brandt. We got Canyon back serving for the Bees. Little by little, they were down 4-0. Now it's 5-3.
Nice block that time. I think that's Fifield.
Oh, Brandt came across.
A little too much forward momentum going and not enough stop momentum.
From the get-go, it didn't seem like they were in sync on that play.
Brings up Levi Olson to serve. Fifield with a good hit.
All right, Bees back at down 2, gives them a chance. We got Peter Lang back serving, gives them a chance to catch up.
Looking for the upswing with the arm catches the net, and they're going to call that one.
Yeah. and Brandt went into the net before their player came into the net, so it was a matter of who violated who first. Lakers up 3.
Cameron Howell serving. Call a lift.
One thing that we've noticed that Brant does really well, he has the ability to see the court as he's going up for the hit, because he's able to place it where they aren't. And that's not an easy thing to do, I can't imagine.
No, it's not. Nice dig there by Lang, unfortunately goes out of bounds.
So trading points for quite a while now, ever since it was about 5-3, so now it's 8-5. Elder needs to get off of that trading points thing.
I was looking for Peter Lang's grandparents, and they're normally here. I'm not seeing them here tonight.
Bonneville gets
hopefully
another one
watching.
Up for. Well, and I believe that we have Brant's brother, Brevin, watching from SUU. Shout out to him and my mother down in Linden. Shout out to her.
She's our number one fan.
She is our number one fan. She does not miss a game of any sport.
Free ball to the Bees and free ball back. And wide open hole in the deep left corner.
Yeah, I tell you what, we're really out of sorts. This is the largest lead that Bonneville's had at 5.
Tyler Cole for his second serve.
I'm not sure how long Mitzi. Oh, that would have been out.
That would have been way out.
Not Brant's fault. They need to be talking.
Nice block. And can't quite pick it up there.
I think we need a timeout here. We'll see if Mitzi agrees. She's got confidence in her team. Good communication there. Sometimes the best way to break a string of points is to let them make their own mistake.
That's definitely a good way to do it. Fifield to serve and an ace.
We need a few more just like that. It was a good set.
Boy, just a little bit on the inside on that.
Yeah, it makes all the difference in the world when you get a good set. Which generally comes as a result of a good first pass.
Uh-huh. Not a first pass like that, but ended up okay.
Yeah, no, credit McKee for putting that in a spot where Buchanan can hit that hard.
Yeah, he put that back there very nicely on that one.
Because yeah.
The pass to him, he had to chase it down. I'm not sure that even blocked.
I'm in agreement with you. Bees back down 3. You know, they started out in a hole down 0-4 and then got down 10-5. They've gotten as close as 2 points. Which is where they're hoping for right now. And that goes wide, so now they're down to a 2-point deficit.
McKee again. Free ball to the Bees.
This is where you need to take advantage of it,
and they do. Buchanan, that was a great pass from Blacker. Good set by McKee and Buchanan with the finish.
And we got a timeout, Bonneville.
We'll be right back.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe
the home you want
is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think Exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent at 801-710-5542.
Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
All right. Thank you, Exit Realty, for your sponsorship here tonight. If anybody's looking to buy or sell a home, please give Stephanie Dixon a call.
So the Bees were down five, and they've outscored them 6-2, and Bonneville took that timeout. It's always interesting to see what happens after a timeout.
And the Bees tied up. Blacker from the back row, a little sloppy getting it over, but they got it. Blacker put it in the right spot.
Down with another great serve.
Free ball. Good pass, good set, and a good block. Fifield puts it deep. Picked up by Howell.
Oh, and that goes
that
long.
Goes long.
So McKee is really on a roll. This will be his sixth serve.
And the backboard kind of got in the way.
Yeah, and I don't know, Talon, we'll call him Talon. I don't know if it's Rocha, but he did all he could to try to get it over and just couldn't make it happen.
Overpass and kill by
Buchanan. Makes you wonder how long Bonneville's going to go without another timeout, you know. If I remember, they took the timeout at 12:10, and Box Elders
added another 5 cents
in.
Yeah.
And that one goes long.
Had a good idea going down that line, but
I tell you what, that angle though, it's so hard. You got to come straight down on it.
I think he caught a little bit of the net, and the net just lifted it that much and sent it out of bounds.
I think you're right. And once again, Buchanan right where he needed to be.
Again, the pass wasn't the best, the set wasn't the best, and all Olson could do was try to knock it over, but Buchanan was right there.
Dallin felt like, okay, I'm on a pretty good roll. I'm going to hit this thing as hard as I can.
That's the rocket arm coming out, right?
Hey, he did exactly what we needed, and we got a pretty good lead now.
His mom's over there smiling, too.
Latter third part of the game. And that's a Bees point. They didn't get that one over the net either. So now we got Buchanan back serving. It's been a lot of fun to watch his progression. He was new to this sport starting out the year.
Thought about letting that one go.
Yeah.
He couldn't get out of the way.
Yes, no, maybe so. Too late. You know, that's hard. That ball is coming at you fast. It's a split decision that you got to do it or not. And another one, four hits. All right, the Bees are up seven with five to go. They've got a pretty good hand.
They were down five in this game.
Yeah, it was 10-5. So we've outscored them 15-3. Somebody came across.
Yeah, they're going to put Olson in the net on that one.
There's Buchanan's so good, they're going to give him two balls.
That can make life interesting.
Oh, doggone it. You know, that might be the first service error we've seen tonight from Box Elder.
No.
Oh, that's right. McKee went long. I was trying to forget it. I'm sure he did, too.
Back around to Christensen. Ooh, nice block that time by Olson. Blacker had a nice hit on there, but
yeah, he did.
Olson was in the right spot at the right time.
And it was a good first pass by Johnston. That was a hard serve to get. It was almost just like that one, but he didn't do that one nearly as well. Coach Stewart giving instructions on where they all need to be. That's the one thing I've noticed is, with it being a new sport for a lot of these guys, they need to be coached up a little bit more. At least that's my observation.
I would agree. If I was playing it for the first time, I wouldn't need that. A little miscommunication out there. Blackard off from the fingertips.
Good hard hit there by Brandt. Now we've got 2 points to go. And we're up 7. So this one looks to be trending our way pretty well.
Duraika serving.
It's a good serve. And we're now at game point. I'm going to assume we get this point. I'll give you an advanced stat. We will have outscored them 20-6.
That's pretty good.
Yep, down 10-5, win at 25-16. It didn't start out well, but about halfway through, it started to click, and they started to play some ball.
They just had to warm up. We'll be right back.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe
the home you want
is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think Exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent, at 801-710-5542.
Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
Welcome back. Starting off game number 2. Looks like Bonneville will be serving, and that will bring up Talon.
Yeah, good luck.
I'm going to say Roca.
Okay.
Kind of like the almond Rocas.
Yeah, there you go.
I don't know. I apologize if I'm wrong. It just sounds good, right?
Good little wheel route there by, I don't know if that's what you call it, but if you get a running back coming out of the backfield to take a pass, that's what you call it.
Hey, Johnny, we can call it whatever we want.
but it was awfully nice, and so the Bees take a 1-0 lead. And a bad set that goes Box Elder's way, up 2-0. Now, this is the point where you got Bountiful maybe second-guessing themselves a little bit. Box Elder's feeling pretty good. You got to continue this.
And look who's serving.
Yep.
How many did McKee have last time he served?
It seems like he had 6 or 7 serves. Good hit by Blacker.
You know, and given the direction that, you know, McKee's the setter out there, and given the direction he was going, that was a perfect set.
Oh, he's an excellent ball player, and he's kind of the glue to this team. And a good reach there. It's a good thing he has a good wingspan, right?
Absolutely.
Bonneville stops the bleeding. They got Christensen back serving. And it sails wide.
It was close, just not close enough. Brings up Buchanan. Nicely placed in the hole there by Tyler Cole. And Levi Olson to serve. Excellent pass, excellent set, and excellent finish.
Yeah, Blacker put it right at him. I think he would like to have gotten out of the way. It might have gone out, but he didn't even have a chance to get out of the way. Nice job there by Brandt. Good serve.
Nice pass, nice set. Nice hit by Fifield. And a block by Fifield right there. JoJo Hall with that hit, and Fifield right in the way. Dirac to serve.
And that
right
went in.
In the corner. I mean, couldn't have drew it up any better than that.
I'll tell you what, Brandt's having a good night. Got a little bit of a smile on his face with good reason.
Overpass killed.
And when somebody's having a good night, you don't need to serve it up to them. Bonneville takes a timeout. Box Elder leads 8-2.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe
the home you want
is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think Exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent, at 801-710-5542. Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
All right, after that of the timeout, B's still up 8-2. Dirac to serve.
Canyon's been serving really well. I think that got blocked, so that's going to be Bonneville ball. And so their timeout worked for them.
It'll bring up Cameron Howell. Got a pair of Howells on the team there.
Sails wide, you know, and if you're Bonneville, that's the last thing you need. You got to at least give yourself a chance. Got to make Box Elder earn it.
Laying back to serve. Great block there by McKee.
Yeah, Fifield was right there as well, so he had zero chance to get that thing through four hands.
I mean, they had a great pass. They had a great set. Just Bees were in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, another free ball for the Bees. See if they can take advantage of it again. Goes long unless it was touched. It wasn't.
I didn't think that one was.
And Peter's been doing a good job serving. I think their serves, we've mentioned it before, that each, well, I jinxed him. I was going to say, they've been getting better. I'll take responsibility for that one.
They would appreciate that, Johnny.
Yeah, I'm sure. Tyler Colback serving for the Lakers.
That set was a little bit behind McKee, but he stretched and was able to finish that one nicely.
And where he's generally the one setting, and it's kind of nice for him to be able to get a hit.
Overpass.
Oh, and he went long
out
on it. Yeah, doggone it.
He's going, dang, I wish I had that one back.
He didn't need to hit it hard. He just needed to hit it where they weren't.
But it's fun to hit it hard, Johnny. Oh,
I can imagine. I can't say that I know.
Excellent. Hustle there by Bryson Howell.
Well, and Fifield, or no, it wasn't Fifield. It was it Fife? It was Dereich, I think. And now I can't remember. But whoever put it across for Box Elder, what a nice job, because it wasn't perfectly there for him.
Ooh.
Ouch.
What did he do to him?
I don't know. It reminds me of back when I used to play racquetball. And yeah, one particular friend that I'd play with, it seems like I'd come out of there with a couple of spots on my back or leg.
Ooh, nice block
there. Yeah, it was a good block.
Samisi Christensen with that one.
Bit of an overpass, the Box Elder gets bailed out.
I think Olson was kind of off balance on that one, kind of stretching for it and not able to control the ball on that hit very well.
And guess who's back serving?
You gotta have some strong fingers when the ball's coming that fast.
Well, and I would imagine that it's got a little bit of movement on it as well. Kind of coming at you like a knuckleball. You got somebody that came across. So, Point Bonneville.
Lang or Buchanan, one of the two. Brings up Christensen to serve.
That sails wide or long. So Bonneville's given Box Elder some points without even having to do anything this game. Good job by Bonneville getting it out of the net.
That's not easy because it's not.
No, they did it twice. Oh, miss hit.
I think Buchanan set that. He's not the normal setter and just didn't quite get it in the right
spot.
Yeah,
and they've done that this game. Dallin hasn't been setting as much as he normally does, and I like that. You're in control of the game, and it gives somebody else the opportunity. And they go back to Dallin there, and we get the point. I think it was Blacker that got that. Just kind of pushed it off of their hands. Made it go wide. Dereich back serving. I think it might have got tipped. It went long. We're quite a ways away.
Officials, what, 4 feet from that one?
Well, and I was going to say, somehow I got off on my score, but they gave the point to Bonneville and then took it back. So four hits. Five hits.
That was an interesting call there.
Yeah, and so now we got another timeout by Bonneville. We'll be right back.
All right, back with Dereka serving.
Nice really good serve. Olsen. Yeah, Olsen, nice done. Kenya's been serving really well.
They drew that one up, and Buchanan's going, man, that was just a little bit too high or yep. too low. Brings up Cameron Howell. Got some Howells in our neck of the woods over here, too.
Yeah, we got Fifield getting that point. Box Elders doubled them up, 20 to 10. I was talking to you during the break. Since it was 10-5 in that first game, Box Elder has outscored Bonneville 40 to 16.
Wow.
That was in.
That was a good hit. Who was it that hit that one?
I didn't notice. I was looking more at the referee to see if he was going to call it in or not.
No, that was a good call. That was definitely
in. It was in. You know, that's a hard thing for those line judges.
Tyler Cole serving that one.
It's out. I thought it might have been in.
That's okay. We won't knock the line judges.
No. They have a tough job. So Bonneville down 8. Serve gone awry. Set gone awry, rather. Blacker once again with the kill.
Like you said, just puts it in the right spot.
Well, and the problem when you overpass like that is you have no blockers there. So that's easy money for Brent. That one sails in or goes in.
Yeah, Brandon that goes, yeah, man, should have got that one.
Yeah. All right. Up 7, 4 to go.
Bryson Howell.
Lofton serve. Got to get this one over. He calls that one in. I thought that might have sailed wide. But they call it in. Bonneville inching a little bit closer.
Yeah, they're only down 6. That was long.
So when I mentioned the scoring streak that Box Elder was going on, since that time, Bonneville's outscored him 6-1, make that 7-1. If I were Mitzi, and I'm not, she's far smarter than I, but I would be thinking about taking a timeout just to stop this run. Oh, they give the point to Box Elder there.
They said called 4 hits, but I don't know. I'd have to go back and rewatch that one.
All right, 3 to go. Had a ball come out on the court, so they're going to redo this.
Thank you.
Lift.
They just miscommunication there by the Lakers. Bees up 7-2 to go. Looking pretty good here to finish this game 2 out.
Fifield to serve.
Well, that went in. So they stay alive. But they need a bunch.
Talon up to serve.
Grant is, whatever he's doing tonight, it's working. Now we got McKee back there to try to put this game away. And he fails to do so. So Bonneville needs 6 to keep this thing going. That's a tall order.
Christensen to face the Giant.
One too many hits.
Nice try. Drake under the net.
All right, that keeps Bonneville still alive. Now they got 4 to go to keep it alive. Push this thing into extra points. And that's the ball game. Box Elder won the first one 25-16. This one they win 25-20. We'll be back for game number 3.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe
the home you
want is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think Exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent, at 801-710-5542.
Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
Game number 3 underway. McKee to start things off. That was a good hit there by Christensen.
Yeah, one line judge called in, one called out, up judge, down judge, called it in. Bonneville takes a 1-0 lead.
Almost a header there to Howell. It's like, if we had more sponsors and more help, we could pull out the radar gun and.
There you go. Olsen had to reach back on that
one.
Yeah,
that one was a little behind him.
Couldn't get it down, so the Bees take a 2-1 lead. And Buchanan back serving. No. Yeah.
Yeah, it's your serve. Free ball to the Bees.
Brant goes wide, and he also hit the net.
Come down into the net there a little bit.
Tied at two. You know, I think there's only been one other tie in either game at 12-12 in that first game. Bees get the lead here for the first time in this game. Well, no, they had it at 2-1.
Dreyka serving. Double hit.
So I think the thing that Boxeller wants to do here, they've got two wins pretty convincingly on both of them. They just want to take care of the business, get out of here, no injuries, feeling good about your play. And that hit in. And that's where, and I don't, what number 20? We don't have that one for the Bees. You're going to look it up. That's not always his fault. You know, players need to be talking to him. And from the back row, Buchanan gets a kill. Bees up 5-3. And that'll bring up Peter Lang serving for the Bees.
I'm not seeing any. Rosters. I know the roster's on there, but. Oh, there we go.
All right, a good hit there by Bonneville. Boxeller block it, but it snuck down over the net. Bees up 1-5-4.
I found where it's supposed to be, but it got no results from my phone here. So,
and once again, Bonneville gifts Box Elder a point. Blacker back serving. And a nice, nice serve. He gets a lot of support here in the stands from his, you know, parents and extended family. It's nice to see. And even a brother watching online. McKee hits it wide. So Bonneville staying with Boxelder on this one.
Keeping it close.
That last game, I mean, when Boxelder got to seven, Bonneville only had two, and it kind of seemed we knew how it was going to go the rest of the way.
Tyler Cole with that serve.
That one, oh, they called it in. I thought it might have been got wide.
I thought it might have been as well.
It seems like I've been wrong about four or five times tonight. And it seems to have been equal both teams, you know, whether I'm right or wrong.
Nice dig, overpass, but oh wow.
Just mistimed it. I was going to mention You know, the nice thing about this sport for me, and I think we can be kind of critical of officials in sports that we know a little better. We don't know enough volleyball to complain about the referees.
You know, I was thinking earlier about bringing up the question, what sport do we complain least about the referees?
Oh, without question, volleyball. Without question. Well, we don't complain too much about softball, baseball either. In part because when we do those games, we're not right behind the plate. We can't see inside, outside very well. You can, being in the trailer, you can kind of see inside, outside. I can't.
If I'm watching the game or because I'm
– Or watching the screen. Yeah.
Yeah.
But volleyball, I never complain because I don't know the game well enough. We're learning, and we hope you enjoy it anyway. I'm sure that they do, to seeing their friends and family playing.
Nice hit there by Christensen. Right over the – ooh.
Oh, nicely done there by Canyon.
Tried to get the foot on it.
And we've mentioned it so many times with the boys and girls. It's not always about the hard hit. Sometimes it's putting it where the hole is.
Absolutely.
We've seen the Reader girls do that for years on the girls' side. Good reaction there by Dallin. See if they can keep this thing alive. Oh, Blacker almost was able to get some control on that hit. So once again, Bonneville kind of staying in there, kind of just close enough.
They're not going away. Talon with that serve.
Nicely done. The Bees get another point, up four. Buchanan back serving for the Bees. Yeah, I think they called it a double hit there on Johnston. So once again, Bonneville's just staying close enough, down three with the serve. And that goes long. It's probably been Bonneville's worst enemy tonight, is way too many service errors, giving Box Setter just free points. Canyon DeReich serving. And Olsen gets it across. Wasn't pretty, but that's all that matters. Get the point. Once again, down three. Been trading points since it was about 5-7, 4-7. Hit the antenna, so Bonneville finally gets a couple of them in a row. Box Elder up two. You don't want them to get any closer and get some confidence. Good serve there.
And Firth comes up a little short on that.
Okay.
One.
Okay, you got the name.
Ryan Firth.
All right, the Bees down one.
Up one.
Or up one, thank you.
Brings up Olsen to serve. That toss-up, I think, wasn't what he wanted.
And they've tied it up. And so we're going to see if Mitzi chooses. She doesn't really use a lot of timeouts. She has confidence in her team.
Cameron Howell with that hit. Looks like Olsen's almost throwing it too far behind him to hit those.
And I was just looking at my numbers here. Had they got that point, that would have been their first lead since it was 12-11 in the first game. And that goes long, all tied up. Good pass, good set.
Free ball. And long.
All right, so Bonneville takes their first lead since midway through the first game.
Bryson Howell to serve. Byfield with a nice hit.
Yep, he takes care of that, and I think it says that's enough. Let's get back to it. All tied up. Blacker back serving.
Well, oh, again, it was a nice block, but the dig on the other side put it right in the hole.
Yeah, it just rolled along the top of the net, and Boxetter finally takes a timeout. Bonneville's got some confidence going on, and let's see if Boxetter can reverse this.
All right, we'll be right back.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe the home you want
is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think Exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent, at 801-710-5542.
Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
All right, out of the timeout. Tyler Cole back to serve. Lakers with a 1-point lead.
Good block there for the Bees to tie it up once again.
I don't know if that was McKee or Buchanan, but whoever it was, I mean, they were there together.
And the communication there on that set before that, you could hear Dallin yelling out Brandt as he was setting it.
Overpass and kill.
Buchanan had to really reach back for that one. Got blocked and went out, so Bees retake the lead. Up one. Let's see if we can keep this thing going with Buchanan back there serving. Or not Buchanan, but
Fifield
back serving. Oh. Bonneville just say, you got it, I got it, everybody's missing it. Three in a row for the Bees.
And another ace.
And Bonneville takes a timeout. Probably a very smart timeout. They had things going, and Boxetter's starting to reverse this.
All right, we'll be right back. All right, just a shout out to the Utah Synergy Volleyball Club team, which many of these young men for Box Elder play on. Kind of hard to joust when your back is to the net.
Yeah.
And that one right there up in the air was Tyler Cole to get that one.
went out, so Fifield still back serving. Bees with a four-point lead. So that gives them five straight points. Hard serve.
Nice serve.
Really, really good.
That's probably the best serve we've seen all day.
I think so. Up five to go.
We can officially call out the serve of the day.
We'll do that. And I was afraid that was going to happen. I wasn't going to say it, though.
He just threw that one and ran just a little too far underneath that one and or didn't throw it far enough ahead of him, one of the two.
All right, Heath back serving for the Lakers. That little wheel route there from Buchanan, he's excited about it. Four to go. Up four to go. That's a pretty good place to be.
Even if they trade points, they'll be all right.
Well, and, you know, we got McKee back here serving, so I would expect nothing more than at least a couple. I should say nothing less than at least a couple.
Nice dig out of there.
That went long.
Christensen with a nice hit, just needs a bigger court.
And another timeout by Bonneville. Box Elder's really just on the verge of closing this thing out.
That they are. We'll be right back after one more word from Exit Realty.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe the home you want
is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think Exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent at 801-710-5542.
Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
All right. Next week, obviously before next week, got baseball tomorrow. We've got softball on Wednesday.
Good reach there by McKee. He's done that a couple of times tonight.
That was a good hit there by Johnson.
Oh, it sneaks across and down.
Cameron Howell brought that to the inside and just off the arm right there of, I think it was Lane.
And another point for Bonneville, keeping them alive, 23-20, but they need a few more. We got to fix the antenna.
Antenna got bumped out just a little bit.
That goes out, so game point for the Bees. Have a chance to close this thing out with Dereich serving.
And that didn't do it.
All right.
Lakers down three.
Lakers need three to keep this thing going. Olsen back serving.
Nice hit. Nice volley going on this time.
Oh, Bonneville gets one of the three they needed.
Yeah, Cameron Howell found that hole in there, kind of bounced off an arm. And timeout called by Mitzi on this one.
Yeah. You know, let's keep it here this time. You know, I would encourage anybody to come out and watch these boys play because it's a lot of fun.
It is. I mean, it's interesting to see, you know, the boys play volleyball.
It is. I've enjoyed it. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. And something that's really, really nice, we mentioned before, it's 72 degrees every game. All right. Bonneville needs two to stay alive.
Olsen
back to serve.
And they get one, so just one more to stay alive.
That was Heath on that one.
Got to win by two. Well, if you're the Bees, you just don't even, you just want to end it right here, obviously.
Overpass.
They're going to call that a point, Bonneville. They're saying McKee hit it last. He's contesting it, but he's not going to win that argument. I think that the argument would have been better to come to the down ref as opposed to the up, say, hey, what did you see? We're all tied up.
And now it's advantage Bonneville.
Yeah. They've got five straight points.
Firth comes back in.
So, game point, Bonneville. Good job there by Buchanan to get that thing back into play. I think they said it hit the antenna, and so Bonneville takes that game 26-24. And that's something Bonneville hasn't done a lot this year, is win a game in region play. I think they got two against Northridge, and that's the only games they've won. They've been swept 3-0 in all the other games. So we go to a game four. And Box Elder's challenge here is to mentally get back into it and just take care of business.
Yeah, they need to right here. Interesting. I'm not sure what the strategy was or is or going in there, but just guessing that they might have thought, okay, we got it won.
Yeah, it's a natural reaction, natural mindset, but Bonneville's feeling really good about themselves, so. Box Elder needs to come out and just take care of business and make it happen and go home. Let's get out of here without any injuries.
And the other thing that they, other than mentally, whether it's 3-2 or 3-0 in the RPI, it all comes out the same.
It does. They just go wins and losses. So there's no harm here, but they need to kind of get their mind back into it. The body language is what I'm looking at now, and you got some serious looks. I'd like to see a couple of smiles, but Scott's down there talking to him. He may not want to see smiles.
Maybe we've been watching girls volleyball too much.
Yeah, they but I think you always play better if you're having fun.
Absolutely.
Now, there's a time to be really serious, and that's there's a fine balance there of smiling, having a good time, and still staying focused. It drives my daughter crazy when basketball teams, after somebody misses a free throw, everybody goes up and gives them knuckles or high five or whatever. She goes, "What are they doing? They just blew it." She's more of the feeling of, like, you know better than that. Go do the job.
Yeah.
All right. So Bonneville, I believe, is going to start off this game with the serve.
Yeah, they start off with Talon Roca.
And Drake does what he does and just places it where he needs to. Bees up 1-0. And strategically, we have Dallin McKee back serving. Comes up just a bit short.
And Christensen back to serve.
Placed well.
Saved well, too.
Let's see if the Bees can take advantage of this. And they can't. Bonneville continuing their feeling good about how they're playing. Well, you hate to see this thing go to a game five.
Oh, yeah.
A game to 15 can go any which way. And once again, Bonneville bails the Bees out.
Buchanan doing his thing.
Dreich with the long arms. Oh, that went in.
That was good. Nice shot there by Olsen.
Bonneville once again takes a one-point lead. I keep waiting for Box Elder to go on one of their long runs, which they did in games one and two. That went out, unless it got touched. Didn't, so Bonneville up two.
Olsen back to serve.
And Blacker goes long. Their scorekeeper gave the point to Box Elder, and that's what it is. Not sure what happened. Must have got tipped at the net or a violation of some kind. All I know is point Box Elder down one, Dreich back serving. And just he's swinging a miss. that'll get us ready for next Wednesday, Thursday, Friday with softball and baseball. A swing and a miss.
A little mistiming on that set right there. And service has been not so hot here for Box Elder lately. A lot of service errors.
No, I'm giving the points the wrong way on my sheet. Bonneville up one. Well, that's a good way to get things back going right. That was almost just too easy. Bonneville didn't have anybody up there to contest it.
That was pretty, though. That was pretty. Whoops.
He came all the way across, so that's going to be Bee's ball.
Sometimes when you're moving, it's kind of hard to stop.
Yeah.
Lang back to serve. So and another service error.
Yeah. That's been a problem as of late. The beginning of the first two games, the beginning of this match, that wasn't as big a problem.
Uh-uh. That's Tyler Cole serving that. And again, Blacker with the finish.
And he's going to be back serving. Be nice to get a pretty good lead here, and that was a good serve. And hit and goes out.
Nice shot by Christensen.
All tied up again. So in this game four, neither team has really taken any kind of a lead.
Just kind of trading points back and forth. Overpass. Nice save. Christensen with a nice hit.
And Bonneville regains the lead.
Christensen's come on here
last couple games pretty hard. Heath back to serve. Nice.
he got Heath, I'm talking Buchanan, he got Heath coming up, and he just tipped it right up over him, all tied up at eight.
Well, he was going up like he was going to hit with his right hand, and then just kind of tipped it forward with his left, and I think it kind of threw him off. Byfield with the serve. Christensen got blocked and went out of bounds. They need to contain those blocks just a little bit more and kind of make sure that they force it in. Blacker from the back row.
Oh, they called it in.
Line judge was kind of running to get out of the way, too.
All tied up at nine.
Little missed time on that one. I think the ball is a little higher on that one, even though Olsen's got the hops.
All right, Bees regained the lead. Not surprisingly, McKee was the one to do it.
Overpass.
Well, and violation, it would have been too many hits anyway, but the Bees get a two-point lead. That might be their biggest lead of the game, I believe. We had a 1-0 and 6-5, 7-6.
Almost seems like they try for the power hit, you know, once they get a couple and get a lead a little bit, then they try for the power hit. And
you know, I think on the key to the serves is to switch it up, though. You got to have some that have some finesse and some that have some power.
Nicely done. Quick set there from McKee to Buchanan, and they didn't have anybody there to contest.
And Buchanan's rewarded with having the serve. It's always nice to go back and serve after you were the one that got the point.
Overpass and there's Blacker.
Blacker takes care of business. Bees up three. They're getting something going a little bit, and Bonneville senses the same thing and takes a timeout.
All right, we'll take one and be right back.
What if you really could have it all?
At Exit Realty,
we believe
the home you want
is right there.
Right there.
And we'll help you find it.
You can count on us.
And you thought we just sold real estate.
We are Exit Realty.
Think smart.
Think exit.
Contact Stephanie Dixon, your Exit Realty Advantage agent at 801-710-5542.
Again, Stephanie Dixon for all of your real estate needs.
Okay, so Bees have a three-point lead, which is the largest of this game, right?
Yes.
Buchanan serving.
And nobody there to get the second hit.
Bryson Howell hit it, and it went up, and then everybody just watched it. That was a good serve.
And a good block, and the Bees take a five-point lead.
Substitution coming in here for the Lakers. Nielsen comes in for Cole.
You Ken has been getting some good serves in.
Ooh,
good block by Olsen.
Olsen was up there and
he's rewarded with getting the serve.
Yeah. I think that's a one-handed block, too.
My memory's not that long. Oh, and that goes in. So Blacker thinks you're not going to do that to me again.
You're on the back row now. You can't do that.
B's up five. Dreich back serving. Kenyon's had some good serves. See if he can put a few together here. Good hit there by Heath. Bonneville gets that point down four.
Bryson Howell.
Not quite. He came up about a foot short.
Tried to loop it just over the net. And like you said, a foot short. Nice block, Fifield. Nice dig. And nice save.
Yeah, it was a good save. Now we need to block this. Oh, that was really well done. We're not getting a chance to get a set and a kill. We're just getting it over. That whole sequence was kind of out of sorts for the Bees.
That was way out of sorts.
They were doing a good job of effort and energy, but couldn't get anything together.
They just never had the control of the ball. There it really goes.
And that's the first time we've seen that tonight, where they go over on the second hit. McKee just placed it perfectly. You know, and that's important to be able to do that, because then the defense has to be aware of the setter as well. That goes long.
Yeah, Christensen had some power on that one. Maybe just a little bit too much.
Yeah, maybe. Blacker back serving. All right, here's where the Bees need to take advantage of
this. Free ball. Pass, set, hit, block.
Once again, an opportunity.
And off of the hands of Christensen. Nice shot there by Buchanan. Overpass and kill, McKee.
That feels good for him. That Bonneville takes another timeout. Boxeller has a commanding 8-point lead with four to go.
They finally got the run.
Yep. Yeah, we were waiting for it, and they got it.
You know, did not have that in that third game.
No, it just never came together, and I'm not sure if it was, it'd be interesting to talk to Metzi after the game or maybe the next game, but what happened there? Was it mental? Was it physical? I tend to believe it was probably more mental.
Oh, yeah.
So this is where – now, we didn't have an 8-point lead in the last game going down near the end, but we had a 5-point lead, and we let it slip away, and they got the game. You just got to put them away and bury them. Good timeout there by Bonneville.
Oh, nicely put by Christensen.
Yep, so they did their job. They got that momentum broke. And Heath back serving for the Lakers. I don't think that the communication was going on there, and the set went a little bit over the net.
I can't remember who that was on.
That he was setting two?
That he was setting two, but yeah. it was the Lakers and not the Bees.
Yeah, I believe it was Fifield he was going for. Good reach there by Brandt. Bees take advantage of a miss hit there by Bonneville. Three to go. Fifield back serving. It was a good hit there. You mentioned it before that Christensen has come on the last couple of games.
Yeah.
He's become a force.
Talon back serving.
And that wheel route, they read it that time and blocked Buchanan for the point.
Christensen stepped it up there again.
Down five. Bonneville still needs a few, but you know they've shown they can do it.
Again, that out of sorts and not controlling that ball.
Down four, and the Bees take a timeout, their first one of the match, or at least of this game. And we'll see if they can reverse this trend.
Yeah, they could use a couple points here real quick.
Yeah, that's 3 points in a row for the Lakers. They just need to get the service back, keep that 4 point, 5 point margin, and they'll be just fine. We're at the point where Box Elder doesn't need a run. They just need to prevent Bonneville from getting a run.
Yeah, so, they can trade points if they have to. But. Yeah,
and that's where I would think, you know, don't take crazy chances. Hit it hard. Hit it where it needs to be, but don't take crazy chances. Boy, and once again, Bonneville bails Box Elder out. Good timeout there by Mitzi.
Yeah, timeout worth the time.
Up five, two to go.
Heard that before.
Yeah.
And blocked out of bounds.
All right, we got game match point for the Bees. And we have our guy back there serving that we want, and that's McKee. He's had a great night serving. And this is going to be an opportunity for the Bees, even if they get it across,
no,
and they don't.
They don't.
All right, so the Bees win in four, won the first game 25-16, won the second one 25-20, lost the game three 26-24, and took care of business 25-18 in game four. And so after the first, so we've gone through the first round of playing everybody. And Box Elder's 4-3 in region, kind of right where you think they ought to be and probably where they'll end up. I think Bountiful, Viewmont, Woods Cross seem to be the class of the league.
Yep.
And Box Elder's right there next, along with Clearfield.
No, it's been great watching them. I think we've only got one more softball or volleyball game here at home. And let's see, that's May 2nd. Then we'll try to do the playoff games if we can.
If the Bees can,
if they get
hold on to this RPI of 16 or better. And interestingly, I said that we're right there with Clearfield. I haven't looked at Clearfield's schedule, but it's possible they lost to us. I don't think they beat Viewmont, Woods Cross, or Bountiful, so they're probably playing one of those teams today. So Box Elder should be in fourth place all alone, I would think. So they need to stay there. I think that's where they probably slot in if you take a look at all the teams now that we've been through everybody.
Yep. And again, we got baseball tomorrow night. Then next Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we got softball, baseball. So
Yeah, no, it'll be a good time. Thanks, everybody, for watching, and